Hi Scorpio, welcome back. This is going to be week of February 17th. It's a general quick reading for the sign of Scorpio. It's not going to resonate with all of you, but if it does resonate, please do like, share, and subscribe. If you are new to me, welcome. If you are returning, thank you. Also, please check out my social media account links down in the description box below. So, Scorpio, see what I got going on for you this week. Why is that a card fly out? The overall message or the overall energy for the week is the Ace of Wands, which is inspiration in this deck. So that's off to a good start. I'm happy to see that for you, Scorpio. The Ace of Wands speaks about having, like I said, new beginnings, particularly like in the creativity sector, but it can also be like passion. Within a partnership, or to me it's the card of like physical attraction almost, but we'll see. We will see how this plays out. So, oh my gosh, she just had a bunch of cards come out. I cannot take all of this. Scorpio, past energy. I've been seeing this literally in your readings. Justice in the reverse. The Page of Swords in the reverse, and then the Nine of Swords. So, not communicating, but feeling imbalanced because you're not communicating. Being stuck in your head, stress, anxiety. Some of you might be having or have been having issues even with like tension, headaches, migraines, insomnia. And like I said, I had been seeing that in the past readings, although I already saw in the love reading for this month that, you were coming out of that energy. So let's see. I feel like a lot of you are coming out of the energy because there is, like new inspiration maybe that you didn't have before. And then you have the Knight of Pentacles, the Nine of Wands, and then the Queen of Cups in the reverse. In this deck, it's the Princess of Cups. So this is coming up in the present energy for the week. Slow and steady wins the race. Okay, Scorpio, I do feel like you're making slow, steady progress. You're wanting to feel like you have, like you can rest at night with the decisions that you're making. Does that make sense? Like that you're making improvements that you can rest easy with. Does that make sense? I don't know. Let me know if that makes sense. So I feel like there's this sense of wanting just to feel comfortable with who you are, comfortable with where you're at, but then there is still this part of you that is emotionally unavailable, and I feel like you're still not fully communicating here coming up in the present energy, so we'll see what that's about. And when I say fully communicating, I mean some of you are not really communicating at all, but come on. My camera's not going to focus. Sorry. what I mean by that is not like fully expressing. You're emotionally unavailable, period. Okay, in the upcoming early part of the week, there's like an emotional unavailability. And I feel like it's because you're primarily focused on stability and finances. Like I said, feeling comfortable. Some of you want to feel comfortable in your finances, literally, or within your home. And a few of you within your partnership. You might be comfort zoning within your partnership if you're partnered. So, future energy. And now, I say that this is a week time frame, but Time is malleable. Keep that in mind. Not all of you are on the same path. So for some of you, this may have already occurred. For some of you, this is all future energy. For some of you, it's present. So just take it as it resonates. The bottom of the deck, I have your card, Scorpio. There you have the Ten of Cups, the High Priestess. I get this in every single reading I do for you. Every single reading. And then the Six of Pentacles in the reverse. So I like this, actually, Scorpio. I like this. I feel like a lot of you are reconciling with someone in the future energy. But it's for some of you, it's not necessarily a reconciliation of a friendship. It is, like I said, a reconciliation of your accomplishments. Being proud of yourself for being able to come out of this past energy where it was nothing but stress and anxiety, and now you have a little bit more stability than you had in the past energy, and it might have taken a whole lot of work to get there. And so just kind of reflecting on that, and I guess being proud of what little progress that you've made, and you should be, you know. But there's still the High Priestess here, which is not fully revealing everything just yet. So there's something that you're still keeping to yourself, and I'll see what that is. Some of you, you might be reconciling with someone that you have an intuitive connection with, meaning like the connection goes beyond the physical. So you might like intuitively know when this person is sad or when they're happy, or you know, if you think of them, you hear a song about them. There's a like an intuitive connection, I guess. And I see that coming together towards the end of this time period. But then you end on the Six of Pentacles in the reverse. Now, I like that in this deck. In the upright in this deck, it speaks of somebody who's kind of looking down on someone else, like turning their nose down. And in the reverse, it's kind of letting go of that. So somebody that you turned your nose down to, Scorpio, in the past, you may be finally letting go of that thought of them, or am I blurry again? That grudge. And that's what you have been needing to do, because literally holding on to it is what was keeping you like stagnant and stuck in your head. And so I feel like a lot of you are letting that go, and that's awesome. So I do want to see the Ten of Cups is. And you got the Hierophant and the Seven of Rods. For a lot of you, this is a partnership that is coming together that you feel fulfilled in this week. Although one of you still may have your defenses up. Like I was saying earlier, if you're in a partnership, I feel like, Scorpio, you want to feel comfortable in the relationship and you want slow movement forward, but you and your partner, or you or your partner, still keeps emotions and thoughts to themselves, still has their defenses up, and this impedes like the progress in the relationship or the stability to the relationship. So it may re-spark and then die just as fast, and then re-spark and then die just as fast. You know what I'm saying? For a few of you, it's that your relationship may be doing fine, but you feel the need to, for some reason or another, defend either your decisions in love or defend yourself within the relationship even. Let's see what the High Priestess is about. Okay, this is only going to be a few of you because this is super specific. Scorpio, some of you part in a partnership that you no longer want to be in, and you're keeping that to yourself. But that's why you're on the defensive all the time with this person. Or they you. You might be partnered to somebody that doesn't want to be partnered anymore, and they're keeping that to themselves. Because they don't feel like there's enough equal give and take in the relationship, or you don't feel that way. There's definitely something being withheld. There might have been some secrets here or lies, betrayal even within the partnership that's not spoken about. Even if both parties are aware that one of you went out on the relationship, you don't speak about it. You don't speak about it with each other, and or you don't speak about it to other people. But either way, it's not healthy. So I definitely see one of the people in the partnership want to be single. They may not have communicated that yet. They may want an end to the partnership. Yeah. Yeah, because somebody's secretly hoping to be free of the partnership. Ugh, that was a few different groups of you. I hope you're still following me. The good news is, regardless of which scenario you're in, yeah, the overall energy is the Ace of Wands, which is a new start, a new beginning. So the energy is here. So for those of you who have been wanting to break free of a partnership, you are able to do that this week, or you feel inspired to finally do that, or your partner does. For those of you who wish to reconcile with somebody, so that's one group of you. There's some of you that have been hoping to reconcile with somebody that you were partnered with before, but there were secrets there. Somebody had their defenses up. And I see that is definitely a possibility this week. There might be a passionate new beginning there. And kind of letting go of past grudges or whatever it was that held the reconciliation from occurring in the past. Okay. For those of you that this is not love, you're not interested in love, it's just this overall energy, Scorpio, of coming out of your head finally. Some of you are making movements forwards, but it's slow progression, okay? I do see coming together. For those of you who aren't in a relationship, this might be with a friend or a family member. But FYI, there's something fishy here with this friendship. Because you feel like you always have to keep your defenses up with this person. You don't fully trust them. For some of you, it is a Pisces or a Taurus. And you feel like you need to use your intuition here, even though you want to let bygones be bygones, or this person may. Okay. So, I hope that helped. That was quite a few different messages. They all could have been for you. Only one of them could have been for you. Take what resonates. I have the signs out. I have, like I said, Taurus, Pisces. I have Aquarius here. Possibly Libra, Gemini. Cancer, Scorpio. And Earth. Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. But it could be any zodiac sign. So if it resonated, it resonated. I wish you all the very best, Scorpio. Until next time, namaste. Bye.